Hello and welcome to another how-to video with the Kurzweil K27. In this video, we're going to go beyond the obviously great sound bank and the vast engine, but really look at how the K27 works as an extremely functional and uniquely powerful MIDI controller, specifically for DAW control. While the vast engine and the sound bank are the heart of the instrument, the large number of physical controllers that we have, such as sliders, knobs, switches, and drum pads, lend themselves in a way to a number of interesting operations. Now, all of these steps could basically work with any DAW, but I'm going to use Logic as an example to show you how to set up a DAW controller. So let's begin. First, let's set up the transport controls to make sure we can play, pause, and stop using the transport section on the front panel. So you want to enter Global Mode, go to the Global MIDI page, and under XMID Transport, you want to select MMC. By the way, this stands for MIDI Machine Control Message. Next, we want to make sure Logic can actually receive these MMCs. So go to Project Settings, and under Synchronization, select the MIDI page. At the bottom of the menu, check the box that reads Listen to MIDI Machine Control Input. With this, the Play, Pause, and Stop buttons on the keyboard control the DAW's Play, Pause, and Stop functions. Now let's have a look at a quick way of controlling your channel strip. I'm going to enter Multi-Mode here, enter 2046 on the number pad, and select the K27 Control Multi. This is going to give me a couple of default controller assignments, as opposed to starting off with a completely clear multi, which is still an option you can use. Next, you want to press the Edit button. On this page, I'm only leaving Zone 1 active, but setting the program to None. Let's move to the Multi main page now. The first thing you want to do is select your MIDI destination. This value is going to be selected based on how you've physically connected your Kurzweil with the computer. For me, this is going to be USB. On the same page, make sure Entry Program Change is set to Off. Now on Logic, I'm going to go into Automation Settings in the Settings tab and turn Automation Quick Access on. And then I'm going to move Slider 1 as an example. So what this means is whatever track I've got selected, Slider 1 would control the actively selected automation parameter. So I press the Automation Key command on Logic, which is A. I can see the default parameter of Volume. So I can click on that and change the active automation value. So this could be panning, plugin settings, or any other automation value that's being read. Now we can also use all of these controllers to trigger different key commands, and of course more nuanced operations, all using MIDI. Now this is really where we can make the most out of DAW control. If you're looking to assign specific MIDI CCs to your Kurzweil's controllers, you can go to the Controls page on the Multi. Next, hold Enter and move the controller you're trying to assign with the intuitive entry feature. Next, you want to select MIDI CC, and then select the MIDI destination. The most common application for this method would be to assign your controllers to existing CC mappings within virtual instruments. For example, if you're using anything from Spitfire, which is known for its large number of control values, you can use these controllers on your K27 to perform real-time MIDI automation. So here's the way Spitfire would usually map their CCs. While we're on the subject of controlling virtual instruments, let's have a look at some unique customizations you can have with how your Kurzweil controller interacts with your DAW. This applies to all of your CC controllers, by the way. On the Controls page, each controller has a set of fine-tuning parameters such as Scale, Add, and Curve. Each of these changes the way control messages are being sent. So Scale multiplies the CC value, which is usually from 0 to 127, by the percentage value that you set. So let's say you have a scale value of 50%. With that, the controller would send a CC value of 63 at the highest point and 0 at the lowest point. This allows you to have finer control over that range. Now say you had a scale value of 200%. This means the halfway point of the controller would send a CC value of 127. Next, the add value. You can use this to add or subtract a specific number from the value being sent. Moving on, the curve value lets you modify the response curve of your CC controller. For example, an expand curve in place of a default linear curve would have more MIDI values in the higher end range of the controller as compared to the lower end range. You can use all of these fine-tuning features in combination to customize the range of CC values you're controlling. Similarly, you can also have the same kind of customization for velocity on the multi-main page. You can select how sensitive you want your response to be, and of course, similar customization features like scale, offset, which is similar to add, and curve. Once you're done setting up your multi, you can go ahead and save it. And just like that, you can have a number of different multis, each built for a different purpose, and switch between them. So you might have multis specific to virtual instruments, multis specifically for automation, and so on. The next application of controller assignments is using Logic's Learn mode, so you can directly assign your controllers to any key commands or operations. This allows you to customize your controllers any way you want. Again, we're going to be using the same starting point of the K27 control multi for this. On Logic, you can either press Command L or Shift Option K to open up the controller assignments window. You want to be in expert view for this. By the way, if you see any existing controller assignments in the right column, you can go ahead and delete them. Now to assign your actual controller, click on Learn mode at the bottom, click on any value you're trying to assign, and act on the controller you want to assign to that value. To quickly call up any key command, click on Show. You can look up the command here, click Learn, and then act on the controller exactly the way you did. Again, with all these controller assignments, always be sure to double check your minimum and max depth values. With anything MIDI, it's usually going to be on a scale from 0 to 127. Moving on, here's a quick demo of some useful operations you can try assigning for yourself. So I'm going to use drum pad number 1 as a record button, drum pad number 2 to make a new instrument track, and drum pad 3 to make a new audio track. Before doing anything on Logic, I'm going to go to the controls page on my multi. In the controller box, I'm going to hold Enter, select each of these drum pads, and change the type to momentary. This to make sure the drum pads work like a single click instead of an on-off switch. Next, I'm going to look up the key command for each of these pads, click on Learn, and then press the pad. Let me also assign some switches. So I'm going to use switch 1 as a key command to select the previous track. I'm going to use switch 2 to select the next track. I'm going to use switch 3 to solo the active track. I'm going to use switch 4 to mute the active track. Switch 5 to select the previous clip. Switch 6 to select the next clip. I'm going to use switch 7 to move the active clip to the playhead position. Switch 8 is going to be for undo, and switch 9 for redo. So I'm simply looking up the key command, selecting Learn Assignment, and then physically moving any of these controllers. So it's basically that exact same process repeated for every key command or controller that you're trying to use. So just with these basic settings, I have my most frequently used shortcuts and easy access right here on the keyboard. With the kind of customizations that you can have, the large number of CC controllers really help streamline your workflow. And hopefully you can try some of these features out for yourself. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.